In this video, learn how to pick a photo from camera roll. It works on any iOS or Android phones. You can do it in 3 seconds only with free plugins. Or you can learn how to do it by yourself in C#. You can save a photo to game folder and load it anytime you want. How to take a screenshot and save a photo to camera roll on your phone device. Export and test it on your real phone. All you need in just one this video. All scripts, free to use. You can download all of these with link under video. To open the project, open this with Unity version 2021. Raw image, object to show photo here after loaded. Button pick, to pick photo from camera roll on phone device. Button take screenshot. Button save the photo to camera roll on phone device. Button save photo to a saved variable. And button load, to load the photo after you saved it. Next, we need to install some free plugins. You can get its link under video. This one to pick the photo from camera roll on the phone. Import. The next one, to save a photo to the camera roll folder on phone device. You will have two of these folders after importing. Open this folder again. Import two of these folders. This folder is script in visual scripting. And another folder is C code. To be able to use this C code in visual scripting, we must add it into the notes. Regenerate notes. Create an empty object. Add new visual scripting script with any names you like. Remember to add this C# script on this object too, that we can call C# functions inside this visual scripting script. First, let's add button. On pointer downs, for button click down. Input, this is the button clicked on. Add button pick. If button pick is clicked, show its name. Do the same for all other buttons. Press play to test the buttons. All buttons worked well. After button pick is clicked on, let's pick a photo from camera roll. I added that function in C# script. Save photo. Open this C# script to understand the code. First, we get media permission from plugin, Native File Picker. This permission to access the camera roll on your phone. After function pick photo camera roll is called, it will check the permission, if it is granted or accepted. If it is accepted, show a message. Then call function pick file from plugin, Native File Picker. If you didn't choose any photos and canceled, print this message. After you picked a photo from camera roll, print message. Variables active scene is a scene variable in visual scripting. After you picked a photo, set the path of photo to this variable. You can add this name of scene variable to easier to call it. After all, unpicked return is an event will be triggered inside visual scripting. It is an Unity event, we called it the first line of the script. You can see this event here. This will be triggered once a photo is picked. Let's print out the path of the photo after pick successfully. If media permission is accepted, we can pick a photo. Otherwise, the permission is not accepted. We need to ask the permission to access camera roll again. Press play to see how it works. Plugin Native Pick Photo is working. If you canceled, it will show a message canceled. Now try to select a photo. You can select any photos you have. Photo is picked successfully. On PC, permission is always accepted. But on the phone, it will always ask you permission first. Now you have the location where this photo is. And this location is saved to this variable. To show a photo to the screen, we'll add photo to the texture of a raw image object. First, get raw image object. Raw image, set texture to add texture. Next step, we need to convert picked photo to the texture. Open folder, sample visual scripting plus. Open to get event to use. To convert a photo to a texture, use this event. If you have Visual Scripting Plus, that event will be inside macro photo sound. Copy it. Back to our script. Paste it here. We already have the location path of picked photo. If the path is correct, it will return a texture of that photo. Press play to test it again. Select a photo. After pick successfully, the photo is showed on a raw image. Let's save that photo and load it. If click button load photo. Open this script again to get event to use. to save a photo to game folder, not camera roll folder on phone. Copy this event. It will be the same in Visual Scripting Plus. Just copy it. Go to button Save. Paste copied event here. After button Save is clicked, save picked photo to game folder. The photo will be saved to a location, somewhere on your phone. It will not on camera roll, not on your game assets folder. You can add the folder and the photo name you want to save. It required a texture input. Let's save the photo texture to the graph variable. Now we have texture of picked photo already. Add it into. If it is saved successfully, it will return the saved path. Press play to see the result. Pick a photo, then click button save. The photo is saved at this location. You can copy the link to check it. The new folder is created. And photo is saved here too. Let's load that saved photo if you clicked on button load. First, we need to save the path of saved photo to a saved variable. You need to use Node, save variables to make it work. We can use these events again. Load photo from a path then show it on a raw image. Copy these events. Paste it here. After clicked button load, load photo from a path. Load the saved photo is done. Press play. After picked and saved a photo. Photo is saved to your game, and its path is saved to a variable too. You can close the game. And open it again. Click on button load, it will load the last saved photo. Next, let's take this screenshot and save it to camera roll folder. Open this script again, to get event to use. You can watch again this video, to know to create these events. It is the same in Visual Scripting Plus. Go to button Screenshot. Paste the copied event here. If button is clicked, take a screenshot. Name the folder and screenshot name to save it. After it's done, you will have a path and a texture. Show the path to debug log, that you can check it. We need to save the texture to the variable too. You can use this one again. After that, let's show the screenshot on the screen too. You just need to add the texture to raw image object. Press play. Load the picked photo last time. And take the current screenshot. Screenshot has been taken and saved to our game. You can check all your screenshots in this folder. If you click button Save Camera Roll, let's add the screenshot to the Camera Roll folder on your phone. Use this event to do it. It need an input texture to save it. Add the screenshot texture you have just taken. Any album name and photo name you like. It will be folder and name inside Camera Roll. Open C# code, understand how it works. You're going to call this function to save a photo. It will use plugin, native gallery, save image event. If failed to save, print this message. If successfully, message success. And you can trigger this Unity event in visual scripting to know when the photo is saved completely. Press play to see the result. Load a photo. Take screenshot. And save it to Camera Roll. It said that this photo is saved to Camera Roll successfully, but it works on phone devices only. It will works on any iOS or Android phones. I will export it to Android because it is easier. Just enter the name of package. Any names you like. Select IL2CPP backend and ARM64. And add your keystore in. All done. Then press build and wait for it to finish.
Bye.